This is Emily from ZYCOO. So for today's topic, it's going to be the installation step for the IP Audio Center. So first of all, you need to download the ISO file from the website. Alright, so inputting our website link. And on click on downloads. Right under the IP Audio Center, there is a installation guide for the second one. And on page 2, you see there is a ISO file link. So just click on the link and the file will automatically download. So it is a large file. It's about like 2 gigabytes. So it probably takes a little bit time here. Okay, so after the ISO file is downloaded, then we can start the installation process. So right here, I'm using a virtual machine. But if you are using a hardware server, it will be a similar process. But you will need to prepare a USB drive, and the drive has to be 4 GB or larger. And you will need to create a bootable USB drive for installing the IP Audio Center. All the steps of how to create a bootable USB drive is on the installation guide. Okay, so if you are using a virtual machine, make sure that you are allocating more than 20 gigabyte storage. I'm putting in 30 gigabyte here. So on a hardware server, you need to plug in the USB drive, press the F11 key, choose the UEFI option, and it will automatically start to install the system. If you are using a virtual machine, make sure that your internet setting is on the bridge option. On if you are using a hardware server, that you don't need to worry about it. So for the whole process, it takes about 15 to 20 minutes. And I guess I will pause here and go back on when it is almost finished. Alright, so it looks like it's almost done here. So when the installation completes, the server will restart. So we need to unmount the USB drive and have the server to reboot. So if you are using a hardware server, you will see the exact same page as the virtual machine showing. And it takes a little bit time for the system to reboot. So for the default credential, username is root and the password is ipaudiocenter@zyco.com. So we will suggest you to change the password after your initial login. And we can see there is a IP address showing above. So just open the browser, input the IP address. If you can see this page, that means you have half success to log into the systems. So just click on advance and proceed. For the default username and password are both a man. So alright, okay. So we have successfully logged into the system.